Good afternoon from Universal Orlando Resort. As somebody who comes to Universal Orlando pretty often, we have to walk through City Walk, and it kind of occurred to me that City Walk is a little bit of a confusing place and there's a lot in it. So we figured we would come out here and give you guys a tour around City Walk and kind of give you some different ways that you could go and different areas that you may not have known about in City Walk. So let's check out everything that City Walk has to offer. We came from the hub, which is the area where the two parking garages come together, and you can see this little green ramp down here that goes down to valet. I can't show you any of that because that's where security is, and they don't like me showing security. So we are going to start right over here at the Hollywood Drive-In Mini Golf. So from the moving walkway off to your right is the Hollywood Drive-In Mini Golf, and there are two different golf courses here. There is the Haunted House one and the Alien Invasion one, which is over there by our next stop here, which is Bubba Gump. So if you go to your left off of the moving walkway, you will go to Bubba Gump's, and if you go to the right, you will go to Hollywood Drive-In Golf. And the largest thing in all of City Walk is right next to Hollywood Drive-In Golf, and that is the Universal Theater, which used to be an AMC, is now being converted over to a Cinemark, but coming soon, Universal Cinemark. So while we're here in front of the theater, I wanted to point out one of the first confusing things. There are two levels to City Walk. So we're gonna start out on the bottom level and kind of go around the entire perimeter, including all of the theme parks. We're not gonna go into the theme parks, but we're gonna show you guys the entrances to the theme parks, and then we will head up to the second level. So there will be a little bit of like kind of backtracking in this video, but hopefully by the end of it, you will have a better idea of how City Walk is laid out. From the movie theater, there is a little stand here that's selling Jurassic World stuff right now. And this stand isn't always here, but it has been here recently. So you can get Jurassic World stuff here. So moving back into the center walkway, which is the main pathway into the theme parks and into City Walk, we are directly underneath the Universal Orlando sign. And this is the entrance to Bubba Gump to our left, and this little Jurassic World cart here to the right. There is a Starbucks coffee underneath here. I don't know if we'll go inside of every restaurant that is in City Walk, but I wanted to show you guys inside of the Starbucks, because in here is also where you would come to get the special Universal Orlando Resort You Are Here mug. Coming out of Starbucks and making our turn around and facing the other way, there are two stores over here that are exactly the same. The Quiet Flight Surf Shop and the Billabong store. There's actually a third store in there too, which we'll show you as soon as we make it around the corner over there, but all of these surf shops are connected. Hopefully this is not too confusing. The Billabong store and the Quiet Flight store are the same store. You can either go in there or go in here. And just to give you guys another example of where it's at, there is the movie theater right there. I also wanted to show you guys there is an elevator. Like we said, City Walk is two stories. And there's an elevator over here that you could use to get up to the second story. So I have a feeling that this whole first corridor area is gonna be us turning back and forth. So turning back across the path and looking back towards the Starbucks, we're headed over here to Concierge, and these guys will help you out with reservations or anything to do with City Walk or with Universal Orlando, but mostly City Walk. Like, you can buy your annual passes here, you can buy tickets here, or make reservations to different restaurants around here. And then just past that is Cold Stone Creamery. And if you guys don't know what Cold Stone is, it is basically just an ice cream shop where they take your ice cream and mix it together on a cold stone, like an ice cold piece of granite. Back out in the center of the walkway again and turning back to our right over by the Quiet Flight store, there is a Billabong photo op here with a little surfboard and a wave. And just past that is the Cinnabon. Cinnabon sells like sticky buns. Cinnamon buns. They're good. Once again, turning to the other side of the walkway, I know that this is gonna be a lot of back and forth. There is an escalator going up to the second floor, back at the Cold Stone now. And then there is a bathroom over here. There is also an ATM back here. CW, City Walk Administration and Health Services, so like a first aid station, are back here. Guest Services over here to answer any questions that maybe concierge couldn't. Turning from guest services in the bathrooms, we come across Red Oven Pizza. It's actually probably one of the best pizzas I've had here in Orlando, and it's fast and it's fairly inexpensive. A little bit further look inside of Red Oven, and here's the menu at Red Oven. Not too bad for the size of pizza that you get. It's not a gigantic pizza, like I could eat one of these pizzas on my own, but I have shared one with Jen before, so I can imagine if you don't eat as much as I do, because I kind of eat a lot, you could get one pizza and split it amongst two people. Once again, back in the middle of the walkway, looking at Red Oven Pizza, and turning to the other side of the walkway, there's a fossil store over here. And this is just, it's just a watch store. They sell watches in there and various other accessories for watches. From the fossil store, we actually come to our first fork in the road where we have to make a decision as to which way to go. We can either go left and head over to Islands, or we can go right and head to Universal, which I think is what we're going to do. We're going to head right so that we can show you guys, because, and I told you guys that the Billabong store and the Quiet Flight store are the same, and then there's another entrance to it back over here. Before we get too far in this direction, I wanted to show you guys that there is a refresh stand over here where they have Coca-Cola, hot dogs, and popcorn and stuff like that. And then all along here, they have all kinds of little souvenir stands where you can get various souvenirs. For example, this one's all sunglasses. This one's various Universal merchandise. That one you can get your face painted or get a temporary tattoo or your hair wrapped. The next one over there is like Deadpool merchandise. But for now, looking back at the fossil store, as we turn to our left, we come across fresh produce, which is kind of like, like a ladies fashion store where they sell like fun beachy type stuff. I'm just going off of beachy because it says beach right there, I think. Yeah, see, I'd rather be lost at the beach than found at home. Beach more, worry less. I'm thinking this is a beach themed store. From fresh produce, we turn to our left again and we come across Peak, which is probably going to be the hardest store to describe. I don't know, it's like interesting accessories, gifts, and designer toys. This will give you guys an idea of what's in here. Dog accessories, but also these things. And a cat vomiting a rainbow. Peak is an interesting store to go into and just see what it's all about. And as we turn to our left from there, we come across Island Clothing Company, which is the other entrance to the Quiet Flight and Billabong store. So Island Clothing Company is pretty interesting. I don't know how to describe it other than the fact that they just sell like Tommy Bahama stuff on this side. And then the other side is solely like surf stuff. From Island Clothing Company, we're actually gonna turn around past what we already saw, show you guys a few more of the booths. Like this one is a Rider Sandals booth. There is a booth here that sells margaritas, beer, and cocktails. And then there is a Fat Tuesdays booth over here. This Fat Tuesday booth sells daiquiris. And you get it in one of these three cups. Depending on the cup size, it gives you a different price. But these are the different flavors that they have available here. And then you can get some beers too. Back over at Island Clothing Company, and we are turning to our left, and as you can see by the large pink building, we're headed towards Voodoo Donut. We've done a couple of videos solely devoted to Voodoo Donuts, and we'll put those in the corner up here. And then I wanted to show you guys also, there is another set of stairs over here to lead you upstairs. We'll definitely be back to show you guys the upstairs and the things on the stairs here, because there's a lot of stuff. From Voodoo Donut, if you follow this person here with the backpack, they're headed back towards the bathrooms. And then directly to the left of that is NBC Grill Brew. Here's a quick look at the menu at NBC Sports Grill Brew as we listen to Eye of the Tiger. So from NBC Grill Brew, we turn behind us and we notice there are a few more booths here for souvenirs. This one's all Marvel stuff. And then directly next to that is Auntie Anne's. Auntie Anne's is a pretzel stop. This pizza one looks so good. Wow. I didn't even know they had that. Another thing I wanted to point out about Auntie Anne's is that they have a little seating section back here for you to eat your, whatever you get in City Walk, really. You could eat your pretzels there or anything else you get. And then from Aunt Annie's, we just kind of look down to our right here, and this is the area where you can take a boat to Portofino Bay, Hard Rock, Lowe's Royal Pacific, or Sapphire Falls. And the easiest way to get to that is just down these stairs over here. And you can see there's the entrance to those stairs over there. There's also a big long ramp to get down to it. From the boat launch, we are turning back towards NBC Grill Brew. There's just another entrance to NBC Grill Brew over here. And another one of these carts that sells, this one actually sells socks. All kinds of different socks. You wanna talk about donuts? We got it. Wanna talk about sushi? We got it. Wanna talk about bacon? We got it. A lot of these stands have these little coolers where you can buy a drink or one of these little fans full of ice water to cool off. From the sock stand, looking past these three giant screens on the outside of NBC Grill Brew, and turning to our left, we are headed towards the entrance or the main arches of Universal Studios, but I wanted to show you guys something. Kind of not really a secret, but a little bit of a secret over here. A lot of people will stop along this bridge to get a picture of the globe or at the exit coming out of Universal Studios to get a picture of the globe, but the best place to get a picture of yourself with the globe is on either one of these two little jutouts or little like outcroppings here. You don't have to worry about other people being around you. You can get a clean shot of yourself with the globe and the arches. I don't know, I think that this is a really good spot for a photo op. And here it is from the other outcropping here. So the first one that we were at is over there. And now we're a little bit further back here. to get still the great view of the arches and the globe. Both of these are actually on the way down to the boat docks to get to the different resort hotels. Now back at the Jumbotron, heading in this direction to head down to the arches that will lead you into Universal Studios Florida. One of the things that I wanted to point out that we can't show you as we get up close to it is if you see this little roof over here, that is the metal detector and bag check for people walking over from Portofino Bay Hotel and Hard Rock Hotel to get into the park. I can't show you it because that is a security area and we're not allowed to film any of the security areas, but here is the front entrance to Universal Studios Florida. Just on the other side of these arches, you can find guest services, group sales, will call kiosks, any spot that you can buy an actual ticket and the turnstiles to get into the park. Turning from the front entrance to Universal Studios Florida, we are headed in this direction. As you guys can see, we are very close to the Universal Ball. If you wanted to get a close picture, this would be the spot to do it, but it is very large and you might need a wide angle lens to fit the whole globe in the picture. As we turn past the globe here, you can see this is the exit to Universal Studios Florida, and we're headed in this direction. Looking back at the globe, the arches are back here to our right. This is the exit to Universal Studios. You can see Rip Ride Rocket coming real close to the perimeter fence here, and if you see this blue umbrella right there, that is where you check in for Blue Man Group, and also there is a side entrance to Universal Studios Orlando that is sometimes open back there. I don't know the exact times that it is open, but if you are confused about where to go here, just look for the Rip Ride Rocket Loop, and also this is where the flagpoles are. Just walking past the check-in area for Blue Man Group, and we're headed over towards Hard Rock Cafe. One of the things that I wanted to point out before we get to Hard Rock Cafe, there is a little area down here where you could walk along the waterfront. There's nothing down there. There are some seats and benches down there, but I think that that's just a nicer walk close to the water, and if you wanted to sit and relax on a non-hot day, because today is definitely a hot day. As we walk up to Hard Rock Cafe, the first thing that we see is the rock shop, and then around the corner is the actual cafe. And one thing I wanted to tell you guys is, if you walk back this way, back to the right of the building here, headed around the back side of it, we came down the side of the building here, and we're just passing by room 315, which is a tribute to CBGB's, but I don't think you can actually go in through here. You can see there's a sign out front that says, please see main hostess for seating. This isn't an actual entrance to Hard Rock Cafe, but it is part of Hard Rock Cafe. The thing I wanted to show you guys was, this is a section of the Berlin Wall. Right here, there's a little plaque out here explaining about the Berlin Wall. You can see some of the graffiti and stuff on it. And then if we look back at the Berlin Wall and kind of turn to our right, this is Blue Man Group. The Blue Man Group restrooms are kind of over here. And then the entrance, the little side entrance to Universal is back around to the right over there. Coming back towards the front of Hard Rock Cafe, just passing by the rock shop again and headed in this direction. One thing that I always thought was real interesting about the Hard Rock Cafe here is that there's a giant guitar out front. You see, this is the fretboard, these are tuning pegs, the body of it's down there. To the left of the rock shop, we come across the Hard Rock Cafe, and this is the main portion of the building. This is the actual cafe. And here's a look at some of the stuff. This doesn't have any prices on it, but it just tells you what kind of food they have here. And as with any other Hard Rock Cafe, they do have a lot of memorabilia in here, all around on all of the walls. And there's a giant Cadillac spinning over top of the bar. I also like all of the fallen angels, I guess you would call them, up here on the ceiling. Janis Joplin, John Lennon, Jimi Hendrix, Jim Morrison, Sid Vicious, Elvis, Jerry Garcia, Kurt Cobain. Real quick look inside of the rock shop. I like that they have this huge thing hanging, what do you call this? This huge art display hanging from the ceiling with all kinds of guitars and musical instruments and such. They also have this huge display of Hard Rock Cafe pins. This is amazing, where if you go to different ones and you collect them all, it spells out a larger Hard Rock pin. And they got like Kiss and Hard Rock, guitar ones. Wow, ones from all around the world. These are so cool. One fun thing to do at the Hard Rock Cafe is come between the hours of 2 and 9 on days where they're not having a concert at Hard Rock Live and ask for a vibe tour, a free vibe tour. On the vibe tour, they will take you to areas that the public doesn't normally get to go to. Like take, for instance, the John Lennon White Room, which is an exact replica of John Lennon's apartment in New York with one of John Lennon's pianos, where they have taken all the keys and had them signed by famous people or famous musicians. Then they reassembled the piano and covered it with plexiglass. Definitely something we have to do one day. Speaking of Hard Rock Live and concerts, this is Hard Rock Live. The White Room is actually right up there. So this is where you would come to go to a concert here at City Walk. So tonight, the Brian McKnight 4 are playing at 9 p.m. So they're all set up to have a concert here, and there's a little sign out front that tells you what some of the rules are for coming to a concert here. So you can't do obvious things like no professional photography, no drones, stuff like that. From the Hard Rock Cafe and Hard Rock Live, we're turning to our left and coming across the Twosome Chocolate Emporium and Savory Feast Kitchen. We've done a few videos from here from when it opened, and we'll put those up in the corner up here and in the description down below. I want to give you guys a quick look inside of Twosome. This is a milkshake counter. This is where you check in to go into the dining room. And then they have a chocolate emporium over here where you can get all kinds of chocolate and Twosome merchandise. Now back out in the front of Twosome, and we are turning to our left and heading towards the main entrance to Islands of Adventure. Islands of Adventure's front entrance is set up just a little bit different than Universal Studios is. You can see all of these booths are for buying tickets. They also have a whole group of will call kiosks over here. If you've bought your tickets already online, then you can just come and pick them up using the credit card that you used to buy them. From the will call kiosks, we can see there's the ATMs over here. There are bathrooms over here. There's a guest services window over there. These are all the ticket booths where you can buy tickets. The turnstiles are back behind those. I always like these. There is one of these out in front of Universal Studios. It was just a little bit further back. This one is a height indicator so that when you bring your kids here, you can check their height against these red marks, and we can see if they are tall enough to ride the different rides. So Hulk being the tallest, and Seuss's High in the Sky trolley, and all of these down here being the lowest. There it is, the turnstiles for Islands of Adventure, and as we turn to our left, we are greeted by the lighthouse for Islands of Adventure, and just around the backside of the lighthouse is Group Sales. That green building back there is Group Sales, so as we turn from Group Sales, we're headed back into City Walk across this bridge here. Now we are headed back in the same direction where we first came into City Walk. You can maybe see the Cineplex sign back there. I wanted to show you guys this little booth over here is actually the bag check and metal detector for the walkway from Sapphire Falls Royal Pacific. And if you're really adventurous, you could walk from Aventura or Cabana Bay down this walkway too. Now we are headed back into City Walk with Margaritaville on our right and Lone Palm on the left. There's a couple of different sections of Margaritaville. This is the Porch of Indecision, which is, I think, just kind of like an area where you can go, and if there's an open seat, you can seat there without seeing the hostess at the actual Margaritaville restaurant. Lone Palm is an outdoor bar where you can get some things off the menu delivered out to it. This is Jimmy Buffett's plane. This is the plane from the song Jamaica Mistake. And if you look really closely, there are little spots where there are patches all around the plane, and these are actual repaired bullet holes. The Hemisphere Dancer, and there is a little sign here that kind of tells you a little bit more about it. And you can see some of the other spots where they've made some repairs to it. So from the Lone Palm, we turn back to the Porch of Indecision. There is a little window over here that is a Surf Shack Margaritas to Go stand. There is the Smuggler's Hold, which is a gift shop or a retail store for Margaritaville. And just around the corner from the retail store, which you can actually get to this from the retail store, is the front entrance to Margaritaville, where you can go inside and get a table and have a bite to eat. This menu is actually very hard to read, but here's a sort of look at the menu for Margaritaville. I would imagine this is probably easier to read at night, but right now, no. Once again, we're at an area where we could go to the upper level of City Walk, but we're not going to. We're gonna stay on the first level and then go up to the second level once we get through everything on the first level. From Margaritaville, across the way, they have a t-shirt stand where they do airbrush t-shirt designs. They can do airbrush t-shirt designs and hats, and then right next to that, another sock stand. Another little section where you can buy Universal merchandise. So trying to give you guys a little bit of bearing, here's the front entrance to Margaritaville. This is the Universal stand. This is the sock stand. There's the airbrush stand, Hemisphere Dancer. There's this little area down here where you can walk along the waterfront, have a seat. I don't know if there are any benches down there. Well, this is sort of a bench, and you can look out over the water and just kind of take it in and relax. And then to the right of us here is a pearl factory. They actually have pearls inside of the oyster still, where you can crack open the oyster and get a pearl out of it. Across from the pearl factory is a restaurant that used to be Emeralds, which is now closed and is being remodeled into something else. We don't know what yet, but something else. Right next to the pearl factory is another little drink stand where you can get appetizers, beer, and cocktails. This is called Shoreline. Here's a look at what they have available here. I'm not seeing any appetizers though. Maybe on the other side over here. Some beers. I found out that their appetizers are actually pizzas that come from Red Oven Pizza over there. From the beer place that gets appetizers from Red Oven, looking past what used to be Emeralds, and in this direction, we've got another little stand, and they sell Dragon Ball Z stuff, which I thought was pretty interesting. From the little stand that sells Dragon Ball Z stuff, if we look to our right, we can see there is a Dippin' Dots place here, and then we are back to where we first split off to the right and headed to Universal Studios over there. I'll head back over to the stairs by Voodoo Donut and walk up there and show those restaurants over there, and then make my way around this way to the second level of City Walk. In this direction, there is a Universal Studios store. Inside the Universal Studios store is just basic Universal merchandise. You can get a lot of stuff that you can get inside of the parks. A lot of different Harry Potter stuff, Universal stuff, Simpsons stuff, Minion stuff, Seuss stuff, lots of stuff in here. From the Universal Studios store, as we turn to our left, there's another way to get upstairs to City Walk, but we're headed in this direction, checking out Vivo Italian Kitchen. So there are actually two restaurants here. Vivo Italian Kitchen takes up the entire first floor of this building. Cowfish Sushi and Burger Bar, Burgushi Bar, takes up the second and third floors of this building. Here's a look, sort of a look, at some of the menu here at Vivo. We've actually never eaten at Vivo, so I couldn't tell you if this is good or bad. We've heard good things about it, though. But one place that we have eaten at a lot is Cowfish, because I do like a hamburger. This is a very, very large menu here. Lots of different stuff, lots of burgers, lots of sushi, lots of burgushi. And then from Cowfish, we are back here at Red Oven Pizza. And so, like I said before, we could go up these escalators over here, we could go up the elevator over there. We're gonna head over in this direction and head up the stairs by Voodoo Donuts. We are back over by Voodoo Donuts. This section of City Walk actually has a ramp that can take you all the way up, or you can just take stairs up either side. And there's a nice little LED light grid up here. I don't know if you call that a grid, like string lights. That looks really nice at night. As we go up these stairs, we are gonna have a little bit of back and forth here. First thing I wanted to show you guys is that there are a bunch of tables with umbrellas up here. So if you get a donut at Voodoo Donuts, or if you go to Menchie's or Breadbox or, you know, Burger King up there, you can come out here and eat at any of these tables. After Voodoo Donuts, the first thing that we come across on these stairs is Menchie's frozen yogurt. Menchie's is a frozen yogurt place that charges you by the ounce. So you pick out all of your ice cream and all of your toppings, and then they weigh it at the end, and however much it weighs is however much you pay. And across from Menchie's is Hart & Huntington Tattoo, which was actually closed for a little bit for a remodel, but is now reopened. I do have to come in here one day. I want to come in here and experience Hart & Huntington with you guys. And across from Hart & Huntington Tattoo Parlor is our favorite place, Breadbox Handcrafted Sandwiches. It's quick, it's pretty cheap, somewhat healthy, won't weigh you down when you're at the park. So you can get a hot sandwich or a cold sandwich, and they're pretty darn good. From Breadbox, we actually turned to something that's pretty interesting about City Walk. Is that there is a restaurant here that is a Moe's, a Panda Express, and a Burger King Whopper bar all in one. So when you go inside, it's like a food court. We came up these stairs down there, and we are now officially upstairs, all the way at the top on the second level of City Walk. When you go inside, it's basically like a food court. So here's the Whopper bar over here, here's Panda Express, and there's Moe's Southwest Grill. Just outside of these three restaurants is where the elevator lets out for the second level of City Walk. If you guys remember back to the very beginning of the video, this is the walkway that we walked underneath, and there's the Starbucks underneath there, the concierge, the Cold Stone. Right here is the Billabong store, and just on the other side of the elevator is the entrance to the Quiet Fly store, but that is the elevator right there. Elevator shaft comes up, you come out, you're right next to Moe's and Panda Express and the BK Whopper Bar. And we are looking down on the Universal Cineplex. From Moe's, Panda Express, and the BK Whopper Bar, we are turning back towards Breadbox right here. And there is an ATM over here, and there's one more restaurant over in the corner over here. This is the Fusion Bistro Sushi and Sake Bar. Just kind of looking back from the furthest away that we can be, Moe's, Panda Express, Whopper Bar, Hart & Huntington, the stairs down towards Voodoo Donut. This is the Sushi and Sake Bar, which I don't know why, but nobody ever comes up here and is, I've never seen anybody eating at this sushi place. Have any of you guys ever eaten at this sushi place? If you have, let me know how it is down below. We've kind of come full circle. We are back at the Hollywood Drive-In Golf. Standing right there is where I did the intro to the video, Bubba Gump Shrimp Company. And now we are headed in this direction which you see this little green covering right here. That is the top of the escalators that lead you up to the second level of City Walk, which we are on now. And the entrance to the escalators is down there by Red Oven Pizza Bakery. Just to kind of give you guys a little bit of bearing, Sushi is over there, Bread Box, Moe's Panda Express, BK Whopper Bar, escalators, Bubba Gump Shrimp Company, leading out to the bag check and the hub and the parking garage. And now we're coming up on the Red Coconut Club. So I feel like this whole area right here is kind of the nightlife area of City Walk. So Red Coconut Club, of course, is not open right now because it is a nightclub for dancing and cocktails, but it's not open right now. Directly across from the Red Coconut Club is another entrance to Cowfish, and you can get into Cowfish here, but you will have to go all the way through the restaurant up to the hostess stand, or if this bar is open, which right now it doesn't look like it is, you could sit out at this bar outside. Looking at Red Coconut Club and turning to our right, we come across Island Market, which is a Bob Marley themed gift shop. So the whole reason they have a Bob Marley themed gift shop is because right next to it is Bob Marley A Tribute to Freedom. This is a Bob Marley themed nightclub. And of course, if you don't want to go into the nightclub, you can stop off over here at Jam and Drinks and get a quick drink to go and walk around City Walk with it. That does bring up a good point. Any of these places around City Walk, you can ask for your drink to go and you can walk throughout City Walk with it. You cannot go into the theme parks with it, and you cannot go on the moving walkways out to the hub with it. Anywhere around City Walk, you can have that drink though. I always like the look of Bob Marley A Tribute to Freedom because I think that this is based off of his home in Jamaica that he lived in. And of course there is a statue of Bob Marley out front. Not only is A Tribute to Freedom a nightclub, but it's also a food place where you can come and get all kinds of Jamaican food. Directly to the right of Bob Marley A Tribute to Freedom is Pat O'Brien's. Pat O'Brien's is a nightclub and a restaurant. Let's go see what they have on the menu. Pat O'Brien's is New Orleans fare. Cajun, jambalaya, bayou, blackened redfish. All that stuff. I guess this is called the City Walk Promenade. Up here, dining, dancing, and cocktails. Directly across from Pat O'Brien's is Rising Star. This is a very interesting place. Rising Star is a gigantic karaoke bar that has a live band. So when you get up to sing karaoke, you actually sing with a live band and backup singers on a full stage with a full band. Across from Rising Star is a little City Walk beverages booth where you can get, you know, various things, margaritas, Lone Star lemonade, Rose Mule cocktails. This is one of the complaints I've had about this area. They try to make it like a party atmosphere. They blare the music up here. From Pat O'Brien's, looking past the City Walk beverages, we come across Fat Tuesdays, which is just a drink stand. There is nothing more to it. You can just get like daiquiris here. Fat Tuesday is a very famous place in New Orleans. I think the most popular one is the Hurricane. So this Fat Tuesday is the exact same as the Fat Tuesday that we showed you earlier as far as prices for the cups and stuff like that. They just have more of a selection up here. From Fat Tuesday, we turn to our right and we come across The Groove, which is just a dance club. I don't know, maybe it's fun? It's like a dance club. It's not really my scene, but I'm sure a lot of people like it. Turning to our right, there are some bathrooms over here. There is a little VW bus, and this is actually an outdoor bar for the Mexican restaurant over here, which is called Antojitos. This is a margarita bar that I'm sure will open up later, but Antojitos is one of our favorite Mexican food places. Here's a quick look at the menu, and I do have to tell you, this is very traditional Mexican food. It is not Tex-Mex, so if you're used to Tex-Mex as your Mexican food, you might not like what you normally like. I do suggest you give it a try though. Looking at Antojitos and kind of panning back to our backside is the Hot Dog Hall of Fame. And you guys remember my bout with Hot Dog Hall of Fame on Hot Dog Day. Here's all their hot dogs. And of course, where is it? There's my 2 foot long hot dog right there. Wait a second, I didn't need to get it with French fries? Oh man. Hot Dog Hall of Fame has different style hot dogs from all around the United States. I think that the Milwaukee Bratwurst actually looks the best, but all of them kind of look pretty good. Looking at Hot Dog Hall of Fame, turning to our left, that is the Universal Studios store right there. Here is where Emeralds used to be, and like we said, it is now under remodel. Another little City Walk beverages thing. And then if we turn in this direction, this is Margaritaville. So we have made it all the way around CityWalk and showed everything that CityWalk has to offer. So now we're back at this crossroads where I said it was kind of a lot of stuff going on. So Emeralds, Hot Dog Hall of Fame, Antojitos is down there, Universal Studios Store, Pat O'Brien straight ahead, Cowfish up top, Vivo down low, Red Oven, the way that we came in, Fossil, NBC Grill Brew over there, and then one more thing that I wanted to show you guys is this stage down here. This is kind of a multi-purpose stage that stays up all the time. This is where when Ant and Deck came, they were down here in this area. They have what's called the Stars Performance Program that comes out here. The Stars Performance Program is if you have a musical group in your school, your teachers or your principal can suggest or put in a application to come out here and have your school perform here on this stage at CityWalk. There's also a sign down here that says that there will be a live DJ dance party tonight, which there's a little tiny thing at the bottom that says weather permitting. So if it's raining, there won't be a DJ dance party, but most nights there is one. So there you have it. That was our tour around CityWalk, showing you guys everything that CityWalk has to offer. There's a lot of stuff here in CityWalk. There are a lot more restaurants that we still haven't tried yet. We have to get out here and start trying a lot of these different restaurants. So with that being said, we are off. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Now it's time to pay the price.